I'm Wyatt with ActionVFX, and today I'm going to be showing you tips to help you enhance your chroma key. If you want your effects to look more professional and realistic, getting a good key is crucial. And we're no stranger to seeing a movie with green haze in the hair, but you know what? We can do better than that. But let's not waste any time and just jump right into it.
Retaining motion blur.
Retaining motion blur on your green screen composite is crucial for having a realistic looking comp, as it preserves the natural flow of movement and helps keep your subject from looking unnaturally stiff or detached from the scene.
Here's a great tip for keeping that motion blur. Use a Luma mat to help key the green screen while preserving the motion blur data. By duplicating the plate, applying a tint effect, and using curves to increase the contrast, you can isolate the motion blur as a range of gray, which helps keep that essential motion blur detail intact.
Then duplicate your base plate again, apply the Luma mat inverted, and mask out just the window region before applying spill suppression to complete the process. This technique ensures that your motion blur stays natural and consistent in the final composite. Once you have your key done and your subject composited from the background, you might notice the color of your subject doesn't match the background perfectly. How do you fix this? Simply go up to Effect, Color Correction, and add a Levels effect. Then you can adjust the level settings to only adjust either the red, blue, or green channel of your footage. Additionally, by clicking here in the RGB viewer, you can switch your viewport to just the red, green, or blue channel, allowing you to match each color between your subject and background. For example, I'll get the red channel active on both, and then by adjusting the levels, I can make sure they look similar on both clips. Then I can repeat that process for the blue and green channels. Use a properly lit green screen. Now, before we go into our chroma key, we need footage. This is arguably the most important part for helping you get a good key. Ensure the green screen is evenly lit with no shadows or hot spots. Additionally, when you're lighting your subject, it's best to put as much room between them and the green screen as you can. The closer they are to it, the more green spill that's gonna be on them. So, distancing your subject from the green screen and evenly lighting it reduces keying issues, making it easier to extract your subject cleanly. Uneven lighting can cause fringing or poor keying results. And if you need properly lit green screen footage to practice with, you can head over to actionvfx.com, where we have a free practice footage library full of cinematic shots to really try out any effect you want. But of course, we're focusing on green screens. However, sometimes you'll need to use something else. For example, if your subject is wearing green. In that case, you'd need to bust out a blue screen, but there are a few more reasons why you might use a blue screen instead. One example is nighttime scenes. Green screens are often preferred for daytime scenes because the color green typically matches the lighting conditions of daylight, creating a clean and even key. Blue screens, on the other hand, are better suited for nighttime or low light environments, as the blue color retains shadows more effectively and can help preserve detail in darker settings. Use key light for keying and fine tuning. Key light is a powerful chroma key effect built into After Effects. That means it's free to use and it's great for green screen and blue screen work. It's highly effective because it offers a range of controls that allow you to precisely adjust and refine the key, ensuring a clean separation between the subject and the background. Here's how to use it effectively. Screen color. Start by selecting the green or blue background color using the eyedropper tool. This tells key light which color to remove from the footage. Screen gain. This control adjusts the strength of the key. Increasing the screen gain helps you remove subtle background hues that might still appear around the subject. Be careful though, too much gain can cause part of the subject to become transparent or reveal unwanted artifacts. Screen balance. Screen balance is useful for fine-tuning the color removal. It adjusts the balance between the red, green, and blue channels of the screen color, allowing you to tweak the key if the background color was lit unevenly and had any of the aforementioned hot spots. Clip black and clip white. These settings help refine the edges of the key. By adjusting the clip black and clip white parameters, you can control how much of the screen is visible, black, or transparent, white. This is useful for cleaning up any remaining green-blue edges or transparency issues. Screen matte view. The screen matte view allows you to see the key in black and white, which helps you to clearly spot any unwanted areas, like color spill or incomplete keying, that need fixing. You can then adjust the clip black and clip white values to perfect the matte and ensure clean edges around your subject. Using these settings, key light allows you to refine your key meticulously, cleaning up any imperfections and ensuring a seamless composite.
The combination of screen gain, screen balance, clip black and white, and the screen matte view gives you precise control over the keying process, even with challenging footage. Fix color spill and soften edges. Color spill occurs when some of the green or blue from the background reflects onto your subject, usually around the edges of hair or clothing. Spill suppressor. After you've applied the key light effect, use the spill suppressor to remove any color spill around the subject. To apply spill suppressor, go to Effect, Keying, Spill Suppressor. The amount control adjusts how much of the spill is removed. Start with a low value and gradually increase it until the edges of your subject look natural.
Once the key is complete and the color spill is removed, you may notice hard edges around your subject, especially where the green screen or blue screen has been keyed out.
Matte choker. The matte choker effect is used to refine these hard edges by either tightening or softening the matte. To apply matte choker, go to Effect, Matte, Matte Choker. Increase the choke value slightly to tighten the matte and remove any transparent areas that shouldn't be visible. Use the softness parameter to smooth the edges of the subject. Increasing softness can make the transition from subject to the background appear more natural. Use garbage mats.
You can use garbage mats to remove any unnecessary elements.
For example, where we can see outside the green screen here. Press P on your keyboard to bring up the pen tool, and with your base footage selected, mask out anything you don't want shown. If your subject moves outside of the green screen and gets cropped off by the garbage mat, you'll need to rotoscope that portion back in, either using the pen tool or roto brush tool.
If you want to learn more about roto brush, you can check out our Red Hulk tutorial linked in the description down below.
And our final tip, light wrap.
Light wrapping is another valuable tool to help enhance your composite. It involves using light from the background to gently spill onto the edges of your subject, creating a more natural blend between the subject and the new environment. We even created a preset at ActionVFX, including a tutorial on how to use light wrap. For more information on that, check the link in the description down below.
And just like that, you've enhanced your green screen composite. If you want to enhance your skills further, don't forget to like and subscribe and hit that bell notification so you never miss a new tutorial. And don't forget to comment down below so we know what you want to see next. Not to mention the plethora of content we already have available, ranging from Nuke tutorials to After Effects tutorials to so much more. Additionally, you can head over to actionvfx.com where you can access the world's largest library of 2D stock visual effects assets, as well as high quality 3D models. And if you followed along, we want to see what you made. So head on over to the ActionVFX Discord where you can share your work with us in the Share Your Work channel for a chance to be featured on our next live stream. But with that said, thanks for tuning in and I'll see you on the next one.